Feresten, thank you for accidentally tuning into my show, and I have a fantastic show for you tonight. Do you guys love warning labels as much as I do? The little labels that companies put on the back of their products because they think we're dumb. Well, we have the king of warning labels. The guy's name is Dick Purtan, and he's going to tell us the top 5 dumbest warning labels of 2007. He's coming up in a bit. In fact, I think I have a couple of them here just to whet your appetite. Here, check this one out right here. This was on the back of a jet ski fuel tank cap. Never use a lit match or open flame to check fuel level. Yeah. No one has to be told that twice. And, this was on a thermometer that reads, once used rectally, the thermometer should not be used orally for sanitary reasons. All right, I have to tell you, if you need to be told that, the flu is the least of your problems, so. Everybody, my first guest has hosted his own radio show in Detroit for 40 years and is in the Broadcasting Hall of Fame. He holds a contest each year called the Wacky Warning Labels and is here to chat about them tonight. Please welcome Dick Purtan. Dick! How are you, my friend?
How are you? I'm doing fine tonight.
Yeah, where are you chatting with us from?
We are, I'm in home, in my so-called library here at the house.
Oh, you're at home. So do me a favor. Could you just stand so I can make sure you're wearing pants?
Yeah. No, I'm happy to.
Yeah, okay. Whoa, hey! Those aren't pants. Those are pajamas. But they're very nice pajamas.
Yeah. This is the Eastern time zone, Spike.
I understand. And thanks for joining us. Now, how long have you been collecting these warning labels?
About 7 years. Bob Dorigo Jones of the mlaw.com has been doing it about 11 years. He came to my show about 7 years ago and said, we want your audience to vote on what's the wackiest of the warning labels. So we open up the phone lines to take about 40 calls, and we get 1, 2, and 3 out of 5.
Yeah. Well, it's great. You know, I think I came across you on the internet, and when I saw it, I said I got to have the guy on the show because these are really funny. Let's go to the top 5 of 2007, I believe, here, right? That's what I have? All right.
Yep.
Here's the first one here. It's for a vanishing fabric marker that warns, the vanishing fabric marker should not be used as a writing instrument for signing checks or any legal documents because it might disappear. Here's number 4, and it was for a letter opener that warns, caution, safety goggles recommended.
For this thing right here.
Yeah. For opening letters. Is that a real mustache?
Unfortunately, Spike, this is the real thing.
That's the real thing, okay.
The nose is real, too.
Just checking. And please keep your hands off your lap. No, I'm joking. I'm joking. I'm just kidding around. See, I'm projecting what I do on the internet. All right, here's number 3. This is baby stroller. Featuring a small pouch for storage that warns, do not put child in bag.
Right.
Wow.
I don't have a baby hand. I got a dog, but he's sleeping right now.
These are fun. And are you already busy collecting 2008?
After this interview, probably not.
Yeah, probably not. No, these are fantastic. Here's number 2. And who judged these? You judged them all?
But 40 listeners to my show on the air. We take phone calls and they pick, the top 3.
I got it. All right, here we go. This is what the listeners picked as number 2. It's an iron-on T-shirt transfer that warns, do not iron while wearing shirt.
Sting, burn.
Yeah, that would hurt. All right, well, let's get down to number 1 here. This is the one I saw that really made me laugh. This is for a label on a small tractor that warns, avoid death. And then, there it is. Look at the picture of the guy right here. Where is it? Right there, look, yeah. Try not to kill yourself, right, Dick?
That's right, pretty simple stuff.
It's pretty simple stuff. Well, thanks for coming on the show. I'm really tickled by this. I think it's hilarious. This is Dick Purtan, everybody. Coming up, we've got the Fight Quest guys, Doug Anderson and Jimmy Smith. We'll be right back.